when Queen Elizabeth II visited the London School of Economics, in 2008, and the global financial crisis was destroying economies all over the world. She famously questioned, "Why did nobody see it coming?" She was not an economist or financial analyst, but her observation was correct. Although some people had hinted that the global financial markets are going to have some structural changes, none of the economists in the mainstream had predicted that. No one knew that it was coming. Welcome to the Isle of Knowledge. Today we'll take a closer look at why economic predictions usually didn't work, and what makes it difficult to arrive at accurate predictions when it comes to economic events. In the year 1974, Friedrich Hayek made an astonishing admission when receiving the Nobel Prize in economics. He famously claimed that in addition to the uncertainty of their forecasts, economists' propensity to present their findings in the authoritative language of science was misleading, and may have deplorable effects. In 2018, Prakash Lanjani of the IMF came to some unexpected and unsettling conclusions in his investigation into the reliability of economic forecasters. His study revealed that 148 of the 150 previous recessions were not predicted by economists. You might be thinking that how they all missed it more often than not. It is true that predicting specific economic events like recessions and inflation is difficult, if not impossible. Although economists have developed many tools and models to help in the forecasting of general economic trends, their predictions are frequently based on historical data and current economic conditions, which have a margin of error. Also, it is difficult to predict how many economic events will unfold in any given situation due to the complex interplay of variables that leads to those events. But why do economists' predictions consistently come up short? Today we are going to find out why. Natural sciences and the social sciences are the two major categories of academic disciplines that study various kinds of phenomena, events, and relationships. The natural sciences, which include physics, chemistry, and biology, investigate the physical universe and the laws that govern it. They use the scientific method, which entails gathering information, developing hypotheses, and conducting experiments to see if those hypotheses hold up. Through empirical data and quantitative measurements, the natural sciences seek to comprehend and explain the cause and effect relationships underlying those phenomena. Social sciences, on the other hand, look into aspects of social interaction and human behavior. Sociology, psychology, and economics are a few examples of social sciences. Social scientists use research techniques such as surveys, experiments, and case studies to understand social phenomena and human behavior. In short, the natural sciences use scientific methodologies to study the physical, biological, and chemical aspects of nature, whereas the social sciences use a variety of research techniques to study human behavior, society, and culture. Economics is a social science. It examines the choices made by people, organizations, and governments related to distribution of limited resources. Economic theories focus on how people, households, and businesses allocate scarce resources and how these decisions impact the economy as a whole. In general, in the field of economics, when understanding the economic behavior of people, businesses, and governments, it draws on a variety of other social science disciplines, including sociology, political science, and psychology. Compared to natural sciences, social science concepts are not precise due to a number of reasons. Human behavior is complex and influenced by a wide range of factors, making it difficult to make definitive statements about how people will behave in a given situation. On the other hand, social science research is often based on self-reported data, which can be subject to bias and inaccuracies. The same concept may have different implications or meanings depending on the culture or time period in question, because social science concepts frequently have context-specific implications. Therefore, the findings and theories from one field may not be directly applicable to another. It is important to understand that the methods used in social science research, such as surveys, experiments, and observational studies, can have limitations and be subject to various sources of error. Now let's go back to the question raised by Queen Elizabeth II, in 2008. Why did nobody see it coming? In reality, recessions are complex, multifaceted events that can result due to a wide range of causes, including social, political, and economic reasons. Therefore, it is reasonable to say that it is not feasible to predict the date a recession will occur, or the severity of it. Additionally, many indicators that are commonly used to predict recessions, such as changes in GDP, employment, interest rates, inflation, can be influenced by a variety of factors, and may not always provide a clear picture of the state of the economy. Although many organizations, experts, and researchers in economics, finance, and business constantly monitor a wide range of indicators and use complex models to predict recessions and provide early warning signals, those predictions should always take with a grain of salt. Economic forecasts are criticized for being frequently inaccurate and susceptible to the forecaster's prejudices. Usually, economic forecasting is subject to a high degree of uncertainty, as it is difficult to predict how global events and political changes are going to impact the economy. Additionally, some critics argue that economic forecasts can be used to justify or support certain political agendas, rather than provide objective or factual information to the public. It is true, however, that economic projections can be valuable in shedding light on present-day economic trends and conditions. They can help governments, businesses, and individuals to make informed economic decisions. Insightful information on potential shifts in interest rates, inflation, and employment opportunities can also be found in economic forecasts. Most importantly, economic forecasts can help policymakers to identify potential risks and opportunities in the economy, and take steps to mitigate negative impacts while capitalizing on the positives. In a nutshell, economic forecasts are one of the many tools that can be used to make informed decisions and plan for the future. However, it's crucial to realize that these predictions are not always correct and should only be used with extreme caution. Always exercise caution when considering the source of the forecast, the assumptions it made, and the information used to make the prediction. It is crucial to take into account any risks and uncertainties that might have an impact on the forecast, such as alterations in governmental regulations or unforeseen circumstances. Use economic forecasts as one of many pieces of information when making decisions, rather than relying on them too heavily. Always remember that economic predictions are often made with a degree of uncertainty, and the predictions are usually accompanied by a margin of error. With that remark, we are winding up this video. Have an insightful day. Thank you for watching. Please consider subscribing, liking, and sharing, which means a lot to me. I love to see your thoughts in the comment section.